So today's reading is taken from Mark chapter 4, and it says this. Once again, Jesus began to teach beside the sea. A huge crowd gathered, so he got into a boat and stationed himself on the sea, with all the crowd on the shore looking out to sea. He taught them lots of things in parables. This is how his teaching went. Listen, he said. Once upon a time there was a sower who went out sowing. As he was sowing, some seed fell beside the path, and the birds came and ate it up. Other seed fell on the rock, where it didn't have much soil. There was no depth to the ground, so it shot up at once. But when the sun came, it was scorched and withered away because it hadn't got any roots. Other seed fell in amongst thorns. The thorns grew up and choked it, and it didn't give any crop. Other seeds fell into good soil and gave a harvest, which grew up and increased and bore a yield, in some cases 30-fold, in some 60-fold, and in some 100-fold. He added, "If you've got ears then, listen." When you live in a rural area like Forfar, you get quite accustomed to seeing the farmers in the fields, getting the crops ready, ploughing fields, sowing seed, and you almost take it for granted. And we have to remember that the people that Jesus was speaking to in those early days and years as he was starting his ministry were from a very, very rural community where the sowing of seeds was important, where the harvest was important. It was important for them to provide food for them all to live on. So it's an imagery that the people would be familiar with, very familiar. It's also an imagery that they're familiar with from Old Testament times. Quite often the prophets would look to times ahead and it would talk about God coming to plant a new harvest. God was going to do something new and kind of regrow them, if you like, as a nation. And this was the kind of words that would keep them going through all of the tough times they'd been through exile, through occupation, the words of the prophets promising something new and exciting and a rebuilding of them ahead was the kind of thing that brought them hope. So when Jesus goes out onto the sea, it was a kind of a natural amphitheatre there. They would have been able to hear him quite easily. And he's speaking to them in this kind of imagery. The first part would be something that they're familiar with, that the God is sowing seeds and this whole idea of new creation, new kingdom, if you like, God's kingdom. However, the second part would have been much, much less comfortable for them to hear, because there's always this assumption that because of their heritage, because they are Jews, because they're God's chosen people, that whatever God comes to do, it'll be with them and they're all part of this new kingdom. But that's not what Jesus is saying. And in actual fact, he's already started bringing in this new kingdom and saying this teaching and doing things that are showing that God's kingdom is there and growing and starting. And yet it's not always being well received, especially by some of the local leaders there. And when Jesus is talking about the seed falling on different ground, it's a message for all of them. For example, he's saying, just because of your birth, just because you were born a Jew, unless you put down those roots in him, unless you put down those real strong roots, then you're not going to be part of what God is doing. You're not going to be part of the 30-fold, the 60-fold, the 100-fold, this growth in God's new kingdom. And I guess for the leaders that are hearing this as well, there's a huge message there, that they're sticking to something that they have always known, and yet it's not necessarily where God is leading in the future. Isn't this a tough one for us? Because here we are, we're still in lockdown, and we've got this little bit of hope for coming out. And as Christians, we've got hope for the future. And I'm convinced that God's going to do something really good and continue to increase his kingdom. Yes, 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold, even though sometimes we see a decline in what we call traditional church, there are lots of new things springing up, and it's exciting. And also in other countries around the world as well. And here's the thing, we need to be part of whatever God is doing. We need to be ready to go wherever God leads. We need to take time to put down our roots. That's what this kind of time is about. Taking time out with God, taking time to hear his word. That's what coming to church is actually about. It's not just about being a church member, but we're rooting ourselves in the Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why it's important that we take this time out with God. But it's also important that we allow him to show us what he is doing in the here and now. Because that's where there was a little bit of friction with the leaders and with some of the people that Jesus was speaking to. There was a reluctance to kind of follow where he was going to lead. And it's important that we follow where Jesus wants to lead us, so that we get our roots put down properly, and that we become part of that hundredfold crop, that new harvest that the Lord Jesus Christ is sowing. And we too can help to sow that harvest. Today, Kerem is going to close in prayer for us. Thank you so much, Kerem.
Prayer for today. Help us, Lord, to nurture the seed of your word, to guard it and let it grow, and to bring forth a harvest to your glory. Amen.